Greetings, everyone. Welcome to the next Let's Play. Now, I don't have the intro videos going, per se. That's because my setup for this is a little weird. If I set it up one way, I can record gameplay, but none of the movies. If I set it up the other way, I can record movies, but no gameplay. So I have a thing set up where I can switch between camera one and camera two, one for movies, one for gameplay. So if there's a little fade in and out, stuff that happens, with, you know, it's normal. So the gameplay should fade back in after movies. I just gotta remember, camera two's game, camera one's thing. So let me write this down here. F1 movie, F2 game. Alright. Now if that's out of the way, let's get started. Now you can't see my cursor on screen. I'm actually playing this on the PC version. But I mainly wanted to start off this LP because a new Star Wars movie's coming out, not made by Lucas. Because I don't want his taint on my Star Wars anymore. I mean, yeah, he's the creator of it, but I mean, I knew I was in trouble after Episode 1 came out, and I was the only one out of my friends who said, I hate this thing. I didn't like it. Everybody else was like, it was so cool, the fight was so cool with Darth Maul, but he's dead. They built him up like he was the new Darth Vader, and he's dead already. I don't care. So, anyways, let's get started. We're gonna select a new game. And you have a choice between three classes. The Scoundrel, who's good at sneak attacks, stunning people, kind of like the Rogue from World of Warcraft. But he kind of sucks. This is for your hard difficulty. You have the Scout. He's not really bad at anything, not really good at anything, though he does get a lot of free perks. He gets, and they're really good perks too. There's stuff that you want, but he doesn't get as many perks as the Scout. Actually, the Scoundrel gets the fewest perks. He gets a bunch of free ones. He gets some free ones too, but they're kind of meh. This is a character you can kind of set up any kind of way you want. Then you have the Soldier, who gets the most perks. Starts out with heavy up to heavy armor. But he doesn't get... But all the perks that he doesn't get for free, you're going to want anyways. So these two kind of balance out, per se. The Scout, though, gets Uncanny Dodge, which gives him more chances to dodge incoming attacks, which is extremely handy. Oh, you have no idea. Then you have just female versions of each. But I'm going to use a Scout, because I like some of his skills. I'm going to customize him. I'm going to portrait. We don't want generic Mongol man, Asian guy, other Asian guy, dude with scar on his eye. That's an ugly dude. Soldier boy. Guy everybody else plays with. That guy. Black guy, black guy, black guy, black guy, black guy, Asian guy. So there's a good bit of portraits. But I'm going to use this guy. Nobody picks him. Attributes. We want 16 strength. I could go for 15, but yeah, I'm going to go 16. Look at the bonus modifier right off the bat. Put everything else at 10. Just to even it up. Constitution, I want at 14 because I want some freaking hit points. And let's see. Dex, I want at 12. I want intelligence at 12, and I want charisma at 12. Wisdom, I care less about that. It's debatable whether I should do this. Actually, I'm going to do that. But that does give me more tech points. As well as it does give you more force points. And wisdom gives you a lot more force points. I'm going to keep the intelligence. It'll come in handy. Okay, skill. Mad skills. Oh, wait, let's go back. Let's go back to attributes. Can I go back? Back! Okay. I want 16 strength, so I'm setting this guy up like a warrior. Okay, just making sure I used everything. I want charisma 12. Because I will be using some persuade. Not a lot. I'm not going to be very good at it. I'm going to put a point to persuade. Two into that. Foreign repair, foreign that, and foreign computer use. Awareness is something you want. Oh, I can't stress it enough. I'm not going to do security, because I don't really need to. I have other characters that are going to be better than me at it anyway, so I'm not worried about it. Computer use, yeah, I could have other characters that are better than me at it, but for right now, I'm going to be the only one using it, so we're going to keep that. I will get more, actually, you know what? Let's do that. This is as high as I can get it anyways, right? Yeah. Because I'm not too worried about computers, because I'm going to use more repair than anything. Repair's got more use than one. And putting up to four is going to be handy right off. Feats! Here's our featsies. We start off with armor proficiency, light, medium, flurry, which is probably one of the best attacks in the game. Probably the best attack in the game. Implant level 1, rapid shot if you're going to go for a blaster type guy. Blaster, pistol, rifle, and melee weapons proficiency. So we got kind of basic stuff. Here we have... Now, anybody that's familiar with any other BioWare RPG of this time? Because yes, this game is made by LucasArts. Amazing game company. And BioWare. BioWare knows what they're doing with some RPGs. Though I don't like all of them. I'm looking at you, Neverwinter Nights. Game's meh at best. Let's see. What we're already proficient in. Now, the implants are the ones we're going to get for free. We'll get those for free. Oh, shut up. Conditioning. Let's see. What are we going to do here? Just two weapon fighting. I'm definitely going to get that. I mean, that's the one I'm getting. So we're going to get that out of the way. Because I'm going to dual wield in this game. It's got more uses than one. Let's see. What is this? Caution. Worthless. This feat gives a plus one skill bonus to both demolitions and stealth. I'm not a scoundrel. I don't need that. Critical strike. I mean, it could be useful, but nah. I think that's what a, is that what a bounty hunter or scoundrel gets? If the attack hits, the target is also stunned. Yeah, that's something that the scoundrel gets. Empathy. Plus one to persuade, awareness, and treat injury. That could be useful, but I don't need it. You just don't need it. Flurry, once you get up to master, once you get, you don't really want to use flurry ever, because you suffer a huge defense penalty while you, for 3 seconds afterwards, and then your attacks have a minus four chance to hit. Now this is based on D&D 2nd edition rules with 1d20, so that's huge. It's not until you get to improved flurry, where everything goes down by just 2, that everything's good, and then when you get master flurry, everything goes by 1, so it doesn't even matter. So not, you don't really want to use flurry until you get improved flurry. Gearhead, you get plus 1 to repair, security, and computer use. Could be useful again, but I really don't think I'm going to be taking that. Conditioning, plus 1 to bonus saving throws. That's a very good one. And then you can get it all the way up to plus 3. That's insane. We got our implants that we'll get for free. That's to equip these special items that you can get. So once we hit level 8, we'll be able to equip all of them anyways. Power attack. Power attack's not bad, but again, flurry's better. It gives you more attacks. Power blast is... rapid shot's actually pretty good. It's like flurry, but for guns. And then sniper shot is like critical strike, but for guns. Then you have blaster, pistol, and rifle proficiency, which you get plus 1 to attack bonus, which means better chance to hit. Heavy weapons allows you to equip heavy weapons, which are basically heavy blasters, and you get a plus 1 to attack for that. Now, melee weapons, this is a tricky thing. You would think, oh, well, this game, you get to become Jedi anyways. Spoiler, you know, like nobody's ever played this before. I've heard that melee weapons and lightsabers are two different entities. They don't go together, so if you take this bonus 1 to attack for melee weapons, it does not transition over to lightsabers, which is stupid! So don't ever get that. Toughness. I'm going to be getting all of toughness because that gives you huge vitality buffs. So that's definitely worth getting. And then dueling. You can either do two-handed fighting or dueling. Dueling, basically if you just carry a single blade lightsaber, you go crazy on people. You get plus 1 to attack and in plus 1 to defense since you're using that. So that could actually, you could make a build around this. That's pretty good. But I'd rather do this to do more damage. So we're done with that. Name! No! We're not going to be lame name. It'll be original. My original name. Alright, everyone, here we go. We got our character, Spetsnaz, the scout. 16 strength, like a boss. So, pretty good little start, alright. I think, yes, I have to go to camera one for this. I remembered. I've got to remember doing this throughout the entire game. I'm going to screw up so much stuff. Ugh. The classic. I am playing as a mouse and keyboard, so it's going to be a little awkward with controls, but I got all the controls set up. Knights of the Old Republic. 4,000 years before the rise of the Galactic Empire, the Republic's verge, the Republic verges on collapse. I'm going to learn to read this. Darth Malak, last surviving apprentice of the Dark Lord Revan, has unleashed an invincible Sith armada upon an unsuspecting galaxy. Crushing all resistance, Malak's war of conquest has left the Jedi Order scattered and vulnerable as countless knights fall in battle, and many more swear allegiance to the new Sith Master. Oh, so they're a bunch of traitorous douchebags, okay. In the skies above the outer rim world of Taurus, the Jedi battle fleet engages the forces of Darth Malak in a desperate effort to halt the Sith galactic domination. Now, I have played the Old Republic MMO, and it's crap. I'm sorry. The gameplay is garbage. It truly is. They never had fixed anything, any of the problems that it had at launch. I don't know, maybe they have recently, but for all I know, that game's garbage. It's just a WoW clone Star Wars. Now, I will say this, the individual character stories, of which there are 8, are amazingly good. So, that was the only thing that really kept me playing, but even then, I started just kind of going, meh. That's a lot of fighters. Oh, that ship ain't looking too swift. I hope I'm not on that ship. I wouldn't want to be that guy. Camera 2. Oh boy. Come on. Let's go. Oh, got some turbulence. Controls should be set up. Random man!
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time.
And the love thing I'm gonna love about this, I only have to narrate myself. Ooh, I can't wait! Who are you?
I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up, we have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive.
I'm sorry, I could be a douche. I'm going to kind of, now, before I get started on anything, I'm going to kind of do my own thing in this. I'm not really going to be good or bad. I'm going to do what I feel I want to do. I'm not going to be Captain America, and I'm not going to be Skeletor. I'm going to be me. So, if I do some dark side stuff, it's because I feel that's the right choice. The holy path is not always the correct path. Or I could just go full on paladin and basically just Xeno scum and then kill something, but I don't know. Anyways, who's Bastila?
Bastila is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really, but she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack. You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I heard what everyone's saying about you. You've explored the farthest reaches of the galaxy. You've visited planets I've never even heard of. People with your skills and abilities are hard to find. It's no wonder the Republic recruited you for this mission. But now's the time to prove yourself. I know you're a scout and not a soldier. But Bastila needs all troops at her side during this attack.
Oath and no oath, I'm in for escape pod. Alright, let's go help Bastila.
So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
Where can I get my equipment?
You can move the mouse to the edges of the screen to rotate the camera.
I've got it already set up.
Moving the mouse while
dummy.
Holding down the right mouse button will rotate the camera as well.
I asked where my equipment was, not for a tutorial.
Move towards the footlocker, hold down the right mouse button, and face the camera towards it. Then hold down the left mouse button as well to cause the character to run forward.
No, no.
You can left-click on an object to select it.
Okay, that's enough. Okay. I don't need tutorials. I have my own way of doing all this stuff. You probably can't see my crosshair on screen, but I have a crosshair. So we get a cardio package, adrenal alacrity, a blaster pistol, short sword, clothing, and two med packs. And I got 50 experience for doing what I'm supposed to do. Oops.
Come on, we have to hurry. The Sith might already be boarding the ship to try and capture Bastila. Put your equipment on so we can get out of here.
Now I know how to equip my stuff, so... Yeah, wrong menu, but close enough. Alright, so we have a cardio implant. Constitution plus one. It's not going to give me a modifier, but I'll put it on anyways. This implant micromanages the cardiovascular system, effectively increasing the user's constitution faster and further than hard work and exercise might. Bam. We have some clothing. These are simple garments that protect a little more than the modesty of the wearer. So no armor buff, but we get a thing. Now, I may be set up for melee attacks. But right now, the pistol's a better option, because I still can fight with it. So let's see. Short sword. 1d6. Critical threat is I basically have to roll a 20 to get a double damage. It's balanced, so if I put it in the offhand, I get a... Plus 2 versus 2 weapon penalty if used in the offhand. Disregarded by most modern warriors, a good short sword can still serve well in combat if the user is skilled. Blaster pistol. Range 23 meters. Alright, it's also balanced. The most common ranged weapon in the galaxy is the basic blaster pistol, firing a bolt of intense, coherent light powered by a replaceable power pack. So we're gonna put the pistol on for now. Anything else I got? Nope. Alright, let's go through the menu stuff. Here's your inventory for the party. That's where everything goes. You can also see all the new stuff you've gotten. Here's my character. You can go light side or dark side. All the things. I can also set up a script for my character, which I don't want to. You can see buffs to certain stats. Alright. This is the skills page, which you've already talked about. Dialogue messages. You can check up on all your dialogue you already previously heard. Map screen. See where things are. And options. Alright.
Okay, let's go. Move out. We should stick together. You'll have more success with a party than on your own.
Okay, this is the party selection screen, blah blah blah. You can add and remove people. Okay, so he has to be. He's a level 3 soldier.
Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry, I've got the override codes. You'll have to use me to unlock the door.
Okay. So here's how you go ahead and select him. First, he has a blaster pistol. Yeah, you don't really want to equip anything on him anyways. He's got a lot of hit points. He's level 3, though. He's pure neutral. He's got a pretty well-rounded amount of stats. And... let's see. Oh, it's from his intelligence. He's got one rank in it. He's got a bit of awareness. Persuade. He's got a lot of security and treat injury, so... not bad. So you go up here to the door.
Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
Right. I got 100 points. We're just following orders. Yes, I know how to move, dang it.
This is Carthel Nassi. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower.
Where's this coming from?
All hands to the bridge!
That was Karth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated.
Yes, let's move out. Okay. Hello, droid. Bait boat, bait boat. Okay.
That door is locked. I don't have the codes to open it. But switch me to the party leader so you can use my security skills to slice into the access panel and open the door.
Hence, why I didn't take any security skill. I don't need it. I was going to have a party member that's got security. Look at the door. It's like security. Tick, tick, tick. Boom. Oh, my God, buddy. Juke. Juke. No, you're getting shot. Oh, you got shot in the dick.
These Sith must be the advance boarding party for the Republic.
Let's do it like Chaz. Let's go. Select him. Yes. Hit space. Let her rip. Hey, I hit him. Look at you, anyone max damage. Come on, shoot that man.
I've got a feeling that won't be our last battle with the Sith. Good thing we have med packs to heal our wounds. It might be a good idea to use one now before our next battle.
Yeah, I know how to use them, and I don't have to use them. So he just gave me some free ones, because I got most of my health still. So, and I got a free one there. Alright. No, not droid bot. Alright, let's keep going. Shoot that guy. What are you doing? Shoot him! Well, it looks like he's taking cover behind a barricade. Yeah, I still don't need to use a medkit. I'm doing pretty good at this one now. Ooh, a frag grenade. Footlocker. They have a short sword, a long sword, and a combat suit. Now, I did a test video on this, and I don't think I got a combat suit. But I will definitely put it on, because it gives me defense of 4. Max dexterity bonus allowed is plus 5. Even the most frugal mercenaries know they need at least some protection from the rigors of combat. Although suits of this type are recommended for light skirmishes only. It is light armor, so even if you're a scoundrel, you're good to go. And it also changes our look. Now we look more official. Also, we are now going to equip 2 swords. We got a long sword. Here's where the roots of the lightsaber begin. The traditional sword still wielded today in many primitive cultures. They are simple and still effective in the right hands. This is a 1 to 12 damage threshold. That's pretty good. Now we can put our two-handed fighting skills to use by equipping a short sword. So now we're dual wielding. Box. Some credits and another med pack. Still don't need to use one. Okay, this guy, I did check him, right? Just making sure. Okay, loot the dead. Okay, now, switch between things in a room that I can interact with. Now, this is another little tutorial thing. The melee combat is so cool in this game. I love all the choreography and everything else. Fire in a hole! Yeah, explosives will hurt friendlies. Be wary of that. Sure, let's go after that guy. For the Republic! Yeah! Okay, I gotta watch my health. Now I'm missing. Come on, kill that guy. Okay, I need to use a medkit now. No, not a advanced. No! Okay. Just a regular medkit. Come on, quickly. There we go. Man, kill this guy already! Okay. Get that guy. You die. Okay, you got him. How about we take out that guy? Oh, look at that! Hence why I dual wield. Man, just ran right through those guys. Now, repair kit. $27. I swore there was more loots the last time I was through here. Oh, there's some. Loot, loot, loot. Alright. Ah, poor boop, beep, boop droid. Parts pile, got more parts. Can't ever have enough repair parts. Oh, the Republic! Do I hear what I think I hear?
It's a Dark Jedi! This fight is too much for us. We better stay back. All we do is get in the way.
Just start shooting at him. So this is our first lightsaber fight, everyone. Oh, you got cut! Last time I watched that, she kicked him in the throat and he fell over.
Damn, they could have used her help.
Ah, we got this, buddy. Leroy Jenkins! Oh, that's pretty good hit. There we go. Take his tail! Oh, good, he's shooting, attacking him. Hey! Don't you use that stuff up, I need that. I could put another blaster on what's his face there. I've already forgotten his name. But, he don't need anything. A vibration cell. That is very handy. Now, did I pick up... Well, I think I picked up... No. Anything else? No. Okay, we're good. Trask, door, Trask. Okay. The door. You there! Have at me! Come on, stupid, hit him! There we go. And I leveled up a dude.
Bastel is not here on the bridge. They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way too. The Sith want Bastel alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Yay! Okay, so we got a backpack. Come on, where's my cursor? Get the blaster pistol. Well, we gotta loot everything. Am I missing something or not? I feel like I'm missing something. A very important thing. I think I'm gonna get it. No, I'll get it in the next room. Oh, that's right. I need to level up. Okay. Here. Level up! Let's go to skills, awareness, repair, and our treat injury is okay right now, so we'll do computer use. Do some demolitions, but yeah, I'll have other characters that can do that better than I can. So, we're good. Feats! Got some feats we're gonna get. Saving conditioning to get plus one to saving throws, because that is very important. Oh, add it. There we go. Now we have, what is it, 20 hit points! And it fully heals us when we do that.
There's something behind here. Damn, another Dark Jedi!
Oh, he's got a bow staff.
You get to the escape pods! Go!
What are you... You can't do that! You're insane! Why would you do that? Trask has bought you the time you need to escape. You should make your way to the starboard section of the ship. Okay, nothing else in here, so let's go.
Loading!
This is Carth Onassi on your personal communicator. I'm tracking your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods.
Roger that. Leroy Jenkins! Cut you up! Waste your time switching weapons. Come on. Attack him. Oh, dang. That was a good hit. Ow. That hit me for one. Look at that. Should be... Nope, there's nobody else around there. Is there no remains? No loots from dead bodies? I want to loot dead bodies. Oh, attack that guy. Let's go. That was a good hit. If that longsword hits, it's freaking over for him. Oh, get wrecked. Oh, dang. There we go.
There's a whole squad of Sith troopers on the other side of that door. You need to find some way to thin their numbers.
And on that
note, reprogram the damaged assault droid to help you if you have enough repair parts. Or you could use computer spikes to slice into the terminal and use the Endar Spire's security systems against the Sith.
The way you win. So anyways, I'm going to cut the video here. I'm going to check everything. Make sure everything's recording okay. And I will be back for more. Take care, everyone.